Namaste everyone. Last class we have seen regarding the Pancha Klesha, means five obstacles: avidya, asmita, raga, dvesha and abhinivesha. These are the difficulties or the problems to achieve asamprajnata state. So by practicing Kriya Yoga, all these kleshas, avidya, asmita and all, by practicing Kriya Yoga it can be small. So it becomes subtle. Like Sutra states, samadhi bhavanartha kleshitanu karanarthascha. By practicing Kriya Yoga, samadhi bhavana, the feeling of samadhi and kleshas, the pancha klesha will become subtle, very small. Tanu means small. Now question comes, whether is there any other method to make it very lean? They get small, but any other method to make it reduced, to make it dilate fully? For that purpose, this sutra tells, te pratipasava heyaha sukshmaha. Te pratipasava heyaha sukshmaha. Let's see. Te prati prasava heyaha sukshmaha. Te means it's related to earlier sutra. Earlier sutra they explained regarding the pancha klesha. So te is the bahuvachanam. It states five kleshas: avidya, asmita, raga, dvesha and abhinivesha. Five obstacles. Here called klesha. Klesha, avidya, avidya, asmita, raga, dvesha and abhinivesha. So five kleshas are known as te. They use this word te due to this five kleshas. So here te stands for five kleshas. Sukshma, let's understand this word. Sukshma means subtle. So when the pancha kleshas, five kleshas become subtle, sukshma what stands for? Subtle. By practicing Kriya Yoga, the sukshma things, the pancha kleshas will become subtle. Before it was gross level. The kleshas were before in gross level. See this picture, you can understand. Avidya, asmita, raga, dvesha, abhinivesha. Before they are in stula level. Stula means the gross level. Now this level is called stula. This level is called stula. By practicing some method, that method is called Kriya Yoga, what will happen? This stula, avidya, the pancha klesha will become subtle, that is called sukshma. So if you see this picture, it will be like this. They will become very sukshma. Five avidya, asmita, raga, dvesha, abhinivesha, all will become insane. Like sukshma, they become. This stage is called sukshma stage. Sukshma, there is subtle level. Still it's there. In this is the state of called sukshma is called, the sukshma stage is called samprajnata stage. So this stage you can compare as samprajnata stage or ekagrata stage of chitta, ekagrata sthiti. When the pancha kleshas will become subtle or sukshma. This is stura level. So by practicing Kriya Yoga, we made our pancha klesha sukshma. Now still we have to work. By practicing certain method, we will make that is very subtlest, means subtlest than subtlest. It's called sukshmaati sukshma. Like this will become like this. Okay, it's called sukshmaati sukshma. Or subtlest than subtlest. Which method we followed? That only tells here, that method is called this method. Prati prasava method. We will discuss on this. Prati prasava. So here explain, by practicing this method, prati prasava method, we will be make our these sukshma kleshas sukshmati sukshma. So if you understand this picture, before starting any concept, any concentration, meditation, the viseha or the kleshas in chitta, they will be in gross form. That's called stula. And the stula kleshas can be make it small, means sukshma, by practicing kriya yoga, tanu karanarthascha. Tanu. The kleshas will become tanu, subtilest, by practicing kriya yoga. So they become subtle, sukshma. Again, that sukshma panchakleshas, avidyadi, can be made like sukshma to sukshma, subtlest than subtlest, very small, by practicing pratipasana. Pratipasana is a technique. By following this, we can make it very sukshma to sukshma, subtlest than subtlest. We can make that. Now, let's understand these two words, pratipasana and heya. Pratiprasava, prasava what stands for? Birth. Prasava what if you say is, what is called? Birth. Means able to give birth. If I say prasava dharmi, like in prakriti, it states prakriti is prasava dharmi. Means who can give birth, have the capacity to give. Prati what if you use, it's a upasarga, if you use this word prati, it gives some opposite meaning. Prasava stands for giving birth, able to give birth. Prati word if you use, upasarga if you use, it become some other opposite word. It's called not able to give birth. Means which stage of chitta or the vidyadi not able to give any birth. Further modification is not done. That state it's called pratipasava. So here now what is pratipasava means? Not able to give birth. Means that strength, that capacity is not there. That power is not there to give any birth. That dharma is not there. Prasava what means? Have the power to give birth. Pratipasava means opposite that. Means no power, no stability, no energy to give any birth. Heya means capable. This heya stands for capable. Or the chitta level, it's capable to give, make, not give it birth. Okay. So, it's, we can make our chitta, we can make all this panchaklesha so that they cannot give any birth, any further modifications. So, this whole sutra stands here, the te pratipashava heyaha sukshmaha. Te stands for all kinds of kleshas. Five kleshas we listed. Avidya, smita, raga, dvesha, avinivesha. Ignorance to dimrittubhaya, fear of death. These are the five known as klesha, panchaklesha. So all these kleshas stand for te, pratipashava, means it can be stopped from the birth, giving birth. So the capacity, prashava stands for able to give birth, and prati word stands for, if you add the word prati, it gives the other meaning, means not able to give birth, not able to produce. Heya means it capable not to give birth. So it's capable, some word is there, capable to give birth, and head what he use, capable not to give birth. So he is capable not to give birth. Like transgender, we say, like they are capable not to give birth. Means they have no any power. They don't have that strength, they don't have that key point to give birth. Hey, he means capable. Sukshma, to whom? Sukshma. Sukshma means already the, by practicing Kriya Yoga, the stula kleshas. Avidya, smita, raga, dvesha, avinivesha, by track following Kriya Yoga, all stula bhuta, stula kleshas become subtle, sukshmaha. Again, by practicing pratipashivaha, pratipashivaha, in a chitta level, they will become sukshmati sukshma, subtlest than subtlest. Still, it's present. See, you can see here. Not delayed fully. So, this stage is called samparigata stage or ekagrata stage, when we can concentrate very nicely. That's not our ultimate. Our ultimate is go asamparigata state. Means sarva vritti nirodha. Means where all these things will delete. Then only it called the highest state of mind or asamparigata state. So this sutra is not possible. They're telling. Some other technique we need to go for this. This sutra is telling that this sukshma, what and all become this sukshma by practicing kriya yoga, all kind of this avidya adi, they can be made sukshma to sukshma, very subtle in this state. So this sutra is bringing us this state, sukshmati sukshma state. Still we need to go for further. Okay. So last sutra you are discussing the sukshma panchaklesha, avidyadi, panchaklesha, sukshma, they can be formed or they can make sukshma the sukshma. Subdrasht then subdrasht by practicing pratiprashivaha. Prashava means giving birth. Pratiprashivaha means not able to give the birth. So when these sukshma kleshas are not able to give birth by following certain practice which is called pratiprashivaha. In chitta level, if you think pratiprashivaha. For example, we told if a item is good, sweet is good. But if you come to know that item is made by poison, that's sweet. Whether you will eat? No, you won't eat. Pratiprashivaha. Prasava means giving birth. Even though you are interested to eat, but by knowing, when you know there is a poison, you don't want to eat. Even though it's a favorite sweet for you, but you won't eat. Same thing will happen. Sukshma means it's a good state, but when you understand that was not the permanent one, then you will try. Then you reach through pratiprashivaha. So that is explained in last sutra. And this sutra will be learning some other thing. It tells
dhyana heya sat vrittiyaha. Dhyana heya sat vrittiyaha. Dhyana heya sat vrittiyaha. Here va is there. Like vrittiyaha. The va. Vrittiyaha. Need to understand. Vrittiya means the vrittis or the thought waves. We explain in first yogasthita vritti in that concept. Vritya means thought waves. Thoughts are good, but at a time so many comes when you cannot concentrate on particular. So you need to make very specific. So here vritya means thought waves. Thought waves. Dhyana, dhyana. By practicing this, this means by practicing this practice means pratyaksha practice, the sukshmati sukshma. The kleshas will become sukshmati sukshma. But still it's present. Can you see it? It's present. By practicing some other technique, it can be fully rooted out. It explains that technique is called dhyana. By practicing dhyana, there won't be anything. Nothing will be there. Nothing. Zero. Full state. So that stage is called asampragyata stage or the last is called asampragyata stage where there is no any further bija, or you can say nirbija stage. Synonym all are nirbija stage, you can say nirbija stage or dharma meka stage, dharma meka samadhi, all this in the concept of same word. So I explain dhyana. Dhyana means the definition we have been looking, we'll be looking in second chapter. Tatra pratya ekatanata dhyanam. When your chitta will become concentrated towards one, ekata, one object, like ekata, towards one, ekagra, stitch. That is called dhyana. So that dhyana, heyaha. Heya means capable. The practicing of dhyana is capable to root out, to cut fully, tat vrittiyaha. Tat root what is here. Tat means it's related to these kleshas, pancha kleshas. So when the pancha kleshas become very sukshmati sukshma, I mean this stage, this is the stage, when it's become sukshmati sukshma by following pratiprashava, then what will you do? You have to delete that, you have to rub it fully from your chitta by practicing dhyana, meditations. You can, there are so many meditations explained. By Patanjali told only definition, like tatra pratyekadanta. So in which practice you can make your chitta towards one pointed, that is called dhyana, whatever you take. Now by this dhyana, all vrittis is related to this klesha, avidya, smita, raga, dvesha. By practicing when it's become pratiprashava, by practicing pratiprashava, when it's become sukshmati sukshma, then you can go for the practice of dhyana. If the vishaya is very gross, you cannot concentrate quickly. Then you need to go for asana, pranayama and all these things. At the end, dhyana. So by practicing asana, pranayama, all this, when the thoughts become very subtle, then only you can pick this practice. Which practice? Dhyana. So the sutra says, dhyana has the vrittiyaha. Dhyana is the method or the trick by which the dhyana is the here what also capable. Dhyana means, meditation. So by following any types of meditation or deep concentrations and the dhyanas, different types of dhyanas are capable. They are having the power to reduce, to cut out the tat vritti. Vritti means thought, it's thought, what you use that word is related to this one. Shukshma vritti in avidyadi level. So here, tat stands for shukshmati shukshma. Shukshmati shukshma klesha. When the kleshas are very simplest and simplest, means this stage, then it can be rooted out fully by practicing dhyana. So later on there will be no any other vrittis. That's called tad vritti. Vritti means thought waves. It will be cut out fully dhyana. By practicing dhyana, it's capable. The dhyana is capable or have eligibility to reduce, to destroy, to delete fully. This all kinds of vrittis. Means sukshmati sukshma vritti, which is present in this kleshas level. So these are the two sutra explained regarding the kleshas, how we should conquer or how we can overcome the kleshas avidyadi. Thank you.